So you want to start a business, but you don't have any money. Maybe you've been told by society that to start a successful business, you need a ton of capital and a ton of money. And that could not be further from the truth. We live in a world where you can start an online business from the comfort of your home with close to $0 to your name. And that is why in this video, we are going to analyze 4 different business models. I'm going to break them apart for you so that by the end of the video, you are clear on the best business to start in 2021 if you're broke. Now, if you're new to my channel, welcome. And for those of you who are not new, you obviously know that I talk a lot about social media marketing agency, which is an online business model. Now, in this video, I'm not going to be rooting for social media marketing agency. I love the business model, but I have no agenda to shove down your throat. So I'm literally going to be taking a look at all these business models from a completely unbiased perspective. So I'm super excited for this video. We're going to hop on my whiteboard, and without further ado, let's get right into it. So it's been a while, here we are on my whiteboard. But before we get into the actual breakdown, I want you to first understand your current situation, because that's actually gonna dictate a lot of the stuff that we're gonna cover later on. So the first thing that we wanna do is we wanna get clear on the haves and have not. These are the things that you currently have and the things that you do not. Now, if you're watching this video and you're broke, that probably means that you haven't started a business before, or that you haven't started a successful business before. So you probably don't have a lot of expertise or experience, and obviously you don't have money. So we're gonna put here, you don't have tons of money, and you also don't have experience. Hope you guys are seeing this, or expertise. So if you don't have these things, what do you actually have? Number one, you've got energy. And number two, you've got time. Okay, these are 2 very, very important resources. And the funny thing is that when we're young, we don't really value time or energy. But I can assure you, when you're in your 40s, 50s, you're really gonna start valuing this. And one of the things that I like to say is that from the age of 18 to the age of 23, even 24, those are your prime years. Those 4 to 6 years are the years to put your head down, grind, work on your business so that you can enjoy 40, 50 plus years of just pure bliss and financial freedom. The funny thing is that most people in that age, what they do is they YOLO, right? They go ahead and they party. They don't really work on themselves. They don't really develop themselves. And that's completely fine. There's no shade in that. I definitely enjoy going out with my friends, but the problem lies in the fact that after those years of partying, they go ahead and spend 40, 50 years locked in a cubicle, working a 9-to-5, pretty miserable, right? And so what you do have right now is energy and time, and those should be put into building your business that's gonna generate financial freedom for you and for the rest of your life and for your family and loved ones. So that is what you do have, and this is what you do not have. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna look at the different financial business models that are available to you right now that you can start online and from the comfort of your home. So the first one is e-commerce, dropshipping, and Amazon FBA. I've kind of put them in the same category simply because you're selling a product online. You have to pay for a product and then you're selling that product. The second thing is trading and investing. I'm talking about day trading. I'm talking about investing in Bitcoin, etc., etc. The next thing is personal branding. Just like I'm doing with this video, I'm putting out content for people to watch, adding value to people, and at the same time, growing my business. So that is the business of personal branding. And the final thing is the agency business model, the service business model, where you offer a service to businesses and you get paid in return. So these business models are horses, and these are the categories that are going to determine who's the winner of the race. So the first criteria is barrier to entry. How hard is it to get into this business model? And little caveat, one of the great things about all these business models is that it's not really hard to get started. The second criteria is cost of entry. How much it costs to get started? How much do you have to invest, right? Especially if you're broke, this is gonna be a very, very important criteria. The next one is expertise required. Then we've got profitability. Basically, how quickly can you get to the 10K a month profit mark? That is the North Star that I'm basing this off of. And the final thing is longevity. Is this a business that is gonna be around in 2, 3, 5, 10 years, right? And not only that, but is this business gonna give you tangible skills that you can apply into other facets of your life? Or is it just a quick fad that's gonna be here today, it's gonna make you money, sure, but it's not gonna be here tomorrow. And not only that, but you're not gonna be able to transfer any of those skills to anything that's applicable and that's gonna serve you later in life. Because if you're young, if you're broke, right, you wanna start a business that makes you money, yes, but also sets you up for the future. So you never have to worry about money ever again. And if you were to lose all your fortune, you'd be able to gain it back because you have the core skills. That is why if you hear stories of billionaires going bankrupt and then regaining their wealth, is because the person you become in the process, as cheesy as it sounds, is actually more important than the wealth you create. Because it gets to a point where you are the type of person that attracts wealth into their life, that attracts abundance into your life. So that is a little side tangent, but without further ado, let's get right into it. The first business model that we're gonna be taking a look at is e-commerce, dropshipping, and Amazon FBA. Now, when it comes to barrier to entry, this is a pretty low barrier to entry business model. All it takes is doing a bit of product research, finding a winning product, setting up a Shopify store, and then getting set up. So it's a pretty low barrier to entry business model. Now, the cost of entry is a bit higher. The reason why that is because not only do you have to pay for Shopify, which is not a massive cost, but typically you have to pay for products, especially if you're setting up an e-commerce store. The difference between e-commerce and dropshipping is the fact that if you're building an e-commerce store, that for me means that you're creating a genuine real brand, which means you are buying product and then delivering that product from your facility. And it doesn't have to be your facility, but the difference is that you're not shipping from China straight to the consumer, which is what dropshipping is, right? So that is the cost of entry. Expertise required. I would say that this is one of the main things about e-commerce. I'm talking about especially e-commerce, right? If you're building an e-commerce brand or a dropshipping brand and you want it to be really successful, you're going to have to master a bunch of different areas. I'm talking about product fulfillment, customer journey, marketing, copywriting, product development even, logistics, packaging, website optimization, and a ton of different other components. The problem with that is that when you're starting out as an entrepreneur, you don't really have much expertise, right? Remember, you don't have much experience or expertise. And so if you're going into this business model and all of a sudden you have to master marketing, product development, shipping times, packaging, you know, customer journey, and a ton, email marketing, right? If you have to master all those components, then it's gonna be a lot of information overload. And the problem with trying to master a lot of things is that in the end, you don't master many, right? And so that is the problem that I see with building an e-commerce brand, especially for beginners, is the fact that you have to master so many things to make it successful, right? And so that is the expertise required. Now, profitability, here is where I also have a bit of a problem with e-commerce. Typically with an e-commerce site, you will have a 30-40% profit margin if you're lucky, which means that you incur a massive cost of goods sold, right? So the money that you make, the revenue, all the numbers that you see on YouTube, all these numbers that you see the dropshippers talk about, that is revenue, right? When you take a look at the actual profit, it's a much slimmer amount, right? So that's the problem that I have with e-commerce dropshipping. This business model specifically is the fact that when you're starting out, you don't have much energy, you don't have much time, right? And money is your oxygen when you're starting a new business. But with e-commerce, the profit margins are not very high. So that is profitability, not very high. Obviously, these numbers and these sizes are arbitrary. They're just comparison, but I hope you guys get the point. And the final thing is longevity. And here's where understanding the difference between e-commerce and dropshipping really pays a lot of dividends. I personally think that dropshipping is a dying business model. And I might get a bit of stick for saying that, but the reason why I say that is because dropshipping stands for long shipping times, bad customer experience, not only that, but bad customer differentiation. In fact, there's this common technique called the reverse image search, where you can take any dropshipping product, you can actually take that image, then put it into Google search, and then you will get exactly where they got it from. And it will often lead you to the place where they got it from in Alibaba. So a lot of the consumers are actually waking up to this fact. And that is why, in my opinion, especially in 2021, where customer journey is gonna be incredibly vital, and also where advertising platforms like Facebook are really cracking down on dropshipping stores, it's gonna be very, very hard to sell dropshipping products. That's why I think it's a dying business model. But when it comes to e-commerce, I genuinely believe that it's a growing business models, especially with what happened this year in 2020. A lot of businesses realize that they have to have an e-commerce component. The great thing is they already have the facilities to do that. They already have a product that has market resonance. And not only that, but consumers are safer shopping online. And that is why I believe that e-commerce is a growing business model. So in terms of longevity, I'm just gonna put it kind of in the middle, right? Dropshipping dying, but e-commerce growing. Okay, so that is e-commerce. Now on to trading. Whoa, if you're enjoying this video, go ahead and take a look at the bottom right hand corner of your screen. There you'll find a little like button. If you're enjoying this video, if you're finding value from the business models that we're covering right now, go ahead and turn the like button blue. For some odd reason, the algorithm finds it extremely sexy when that thing is blue, and I would really appreciate it. So with that being said, let's get back into the video. When it comes to trading, I would say that the barrier to entry is pretty much the same. You don't need much to get started. You don't need a certification or anything that will allow you to trade online. The cost of entry, again, very, very minimal, right? The expertise required, I would say that is probably a lot more than e-commerce, simply because number one, you're betting your own money, which is also the case when you start an e-commerce business, but you really need to know what you're doing to actually make money with it. And that actually leads me to the next point, which is profitability. Now, this can be quite profitable, but the thing about trading is that you're not really building a real business. In fact, I've included trading here, but I don't really consider trading a business. And the reason why that is because you're not adding value to people. You're literally betting and gambling whether the market is gonna go up or down, right? There's no longevity to that, which leads me to the next point. There's no longevity to it because you cannot time the market. You cannot predict whether the stock is gonna go up or down. If I were to ask any trader how much money they're gonna make next month, they wouldn't be able to tell me. And that, at least to me, is not a very viable business model. So that is trading and investing. The next thing is personal branding. Now, the barrier to entry is super, super small, right? All you need is pretty much a camera, decent lighting, a bit of audio, and then social media platforms. Now, the cost of entry, again, pretty small. You can literally film with your phone at this point. The expertise required. And here is the problem with personal branding, right? You don't really need a lot of expertise to start putting out content. The thing is, if you don't have that expertise, if you haven't actually walked the talk on what you're teaching others, it's not really gonna resonate with the market. And if it does resonate, it's not really gonna have an impact, because the people that apply those principles that are just rejuvenated from books and courses that maybe you've taken, that's not gonna have much of an impact on them, because there's no better way of teaching than sharing your own knowledge, because you know that that one thing is true. The stuff that you've read in books or maybe you watch on courses, you don't really know whether that stuff works or not. You don't even know if it worked for the course creator. So when it comes to expertise, if you really wanna stand out in the personal branding space, you need to have quite a lot of expertise. And the thing is, you cannot garner this expertise if you haven't actually been through the process and built one of these businesses. So as a starting business model, personal branding is probably not a very good idea. Now, if your personal brand is in the entertainment space, maybe like a Logan Paul or a David Dobrik, then it's a completely different story, but you really need to find your angle and what you stand for that's completely different to what's out there in the market. So that is expertise required. Profitability, I would say that it is highly profitable, because you don't have many expenses. You don't really incur many expenses, especially if you don't have a team around you. At this point, obviously, my personal brand, I have got a video editor, I've got a person who writes copy. So I do incur more expenses, but that's because my time and energy goes towards my main business. If I was only doing my personal brand, I would probably not need a whole team, right? I would probably grow less, but the point is, it's very profitable because you don't have many expenses. And the final thing is longevity. This one's a bit of a tricky one, but I truly believe that once you build an audience with a personal brand, you're probably never gonna go broke again. Because when you have eyeballs, you have attention, and attention equals money, right? When you have attention, when you have eyeballs on what you're doing, people are gonna be able to find you and people are gonna buy your products or your services, whatever you have to offer. So in terms of longevity, I would say that it stands here. Cool, now we're down to the final business model, which is the agency service-based business model. For those of you who are not familiar with this business model, what it is you offer an in-demand online service, for example, Facebook ads, to a specific niche, a group of people that share similar traits and similar characteristics between them. And for carrying out that service, you get paid a monthly retainer. Now, if a client is paying you 2K a month and you have five of those clients, then you're already at 10K a month. So the barrier to entry, pretty minimal again. That is a recurring theme with a lot of these business models that we're speaking about. Now, in terms of the barrier to entry, is very minimal. Pretty much anyone can get started, which I actually see as an advantage. A lot of people think that it's gonna saturate the market. It does saturate the market with a lot of people who have a big, big mouth, but never implement, right? And so the percentage of people that actually implement are very, very minimal. And the percentage of people that are actually implementing the right information and have the right guidance on how to execute properly is very minimal. So that is the barrier to entry. Then the next thing is the cost of entry, which is also very, very minimal. You pretty much only need a bunch of different softwares, which I'll probably talk about at the end of this video. In terms of the expertise required, very, very minimal as well. Obviously, you're gonna grow as a marketer, as a digital marketer. If you're offering Facebook ads, you're gonna grow as a Facebook ads expert in the upcoming months, but not being a Facebook ads expert right now does not prevent you from going out and selling your service and signing new clients. And the reason why that is because when we're building an agency, you go ahead and hire a contractor who does the service for you. And so essentially all you're focusing on at first is signing clients. And when you sign a client, the contractor does this service delivery, you can sign more clients. Not only that, but the contractor who is an expert at Facebook ads, your service, can get them incredible results. So that is the expertise required. Now the profitability is pretty blissful. And the reason why that is because all you make, you pretty much get to keep, except for obviously the cost of the contractor. So you can expect 80, 85 to 90% profit margins. Compare those to e-commerce where you have 30, 40% profit margins, which is great for beginners and people who are completely broke, because in 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, if you execute properly, you can look at your bank account and you can have a pretty decent number in there because it's almost pure profit. Now, the final criteria is longevity. And for the agency business model, I would probably put it on the same level as personal branding or even just a bit more. And the reason why that is because agencies are going nowhere. Businesses will always need marketing and they will need marketing agencies to take care of their marketing. platforms may change and you may have to pivot your service, right? So for example, if next year Facebook ads is not very hot and it's not very profitable for clients, then you might have to switch to TikTok ads or Snapchat ads or Google ads, whatever platform it is that you can use to get the highest returns on investment for your clients, you can just pretty much pivot to that service. And that is why I love the agency business model, because it has true longevity. And the final thing is, personally, as an individual, it has true longevity because it gives you transferable skills that you can apply later on in your life. When you're building your marketing agency, when you're helping e-com brands, just like these guys right here, when you're helping them grow online and you're just doing the marketing, you're actually gonna gain a ton of experience on product fulfillment, product development, what some of the biggest e-commerce brands are doing to take their business to the 7- and 8-figure mark. And so you're adding a ton of value to them via your service, for example, Facebook ads, right? And you're helping them grow, but they're also adding a ton of value to you, because just by working with them, you're soaking up so much knowledge about what it takes to build a successful customer journey, a highly engaged brand, or a very profitable tribe online. So that is why I also love the agency business model, because it has true transferable skills that you can apply later on in different business models, like for example, e-commerce or personal branding. So in conclusion, I'm taking a look at all the 4 different business models that we've analyzed, taking a look at the different criteria we've taken a look at. We've got a clear winner, and that is the agency business model. Now, if you've enjoyed this video, go ahead and smash the like button. And before you start the agency model, there's a few things that you're going to want to know, especially as 2021 is just around the corner. And the main thing is the difference between an EMA and an SMMA that you might have heard of already. So I'm going to leave the video right here so you can check it out, and I will see you there. Peace.